here just bowled a little bit ago, and we're going to go through the process of using the Udderly Easy Milker. I'm going to put the stabilizer on her first because a lot of times people are alone and they have nobody to help them, and this helps facilitate getting the be able to draw the colostrum from the mare. I'm going to go ahead and apply the stabilizer first, just like it, the directions say, but underneath the top lip, pull it down, set it, and because I don't want to turn her, the foals here in the stall, I'm going to trigger this 6, 8, 10 times, and then I'll pull it and set the tension on it. See, it always goes back to where the button was set, and then once I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and pull it down because the head sets the pressure and lock it up. And for the next couple minutes, I'll just, while I'm getting the Udderly Easy ready to go, I'll just leave her alone. The very next process is I'm going to wipe the bag off with the Udderly Easy wipes that come into the kit. And this is very critical. You want a clean bag before that baby gets up and starts nursing, because you want to get the bacteria off of it and get that colostrum in there as soon as you can. Go up underneath there. As you can see, the wax plugs on this mare. We'll take that off. And always strip them a little bit. Make sure you got that bacteria out of the end of the teat. And then take and wipe that bag off very, very good. You've always got manure, and there's nothing more infectious than after the foaling process. We always give bay these bags on our mares before they do foal, however, so we don't have a lot of that crud that you normally get on a bag that hasn't been cleaned. So basically this is antiseptic for antiseptic reasons now.
Okay. Sure. Fine.
I've already wiped the teats off and stripped them, and always make sure that you got that a good flow started on both teat. As you go up underneath the teat with the Udderly Easy Milker, position it, slightly tip your bottle away from the pump so you got a good vacuum lock. You start drawing the teat down into the pump, push it up into the udder like the baby would bunt it, and then let the weight come down on it. And here comes the colostrum. I'm going to break the vacuum. I'll push the bottle back. I'll go onto the other teat from the other side. You do not have to go onto the other side when you're drawing the colostrum from the mares. As soon as it slows down, you can go ahead and pump it up again. I'll tip that out of there. This way we're keeping the bag pretty well even as we're pulling the colostrum out of them. I'll go back over here again and finish off this 8 ounces. Release that one. I'll go back here again. I like to keep them even. You can see it's filling right up. Both orifices are filling the milk going down into the bottle. I release it again. Now, what we've done in this last year to be able to stop cross-contamination, just simply screw off the bottle. We went ahead and manufactured a lid that you can put right on there so you don't have any cross-contamination. And we're ready to go ahead and start giving this baby the mother's first milk. A baby's strongest suckle reflex action is always at birth. A lot of times if you just take your finger and put it on the roof of that mouth and palpate it a little bit, it'll start wrapping its tongue around your finger. And then at that point, go ahead and insert the bottle. And always try and keep the... Lift his shoulder up a little bit more, and put your knee underneath. Okay. Always try and keep the... from giving the baby the colostrum laying flat down, and it eliminates getting into the lungs. With these new caps that we've invented, we have an airflow going right into that bottle now. So you can see how fast he's draining that 8 ounces. And it's very critical because of septic pole syndrome that you get this colostrum into these foals as fast as possible. This baby's taking this down literally. Now with the holes that we've invented with the caps on here, because most baby bottles are made, they have the European threads on them, so they didn't fit our bottles. But we went ahead and invested to be able to put this on there. Probably within a minute or less, it's taken the 8 ounces. It's completely empty. Our veterinarian is here. We've had a little bleed back on the navel on this foal this morning, so we're going to go ahead and have her check that process out, and then we'll milk another. We'll let it lay here a little bit, and we'll milk another 8 ounces out. As you can tell, that stabilizer's been on that mare about 3 minutes now, and she's totally relaxed. And Dr. Jennifer Bauer from the Clarksville Veterinary Clinic has came out to go ahead and tie off this navel a little more, because we had some bleed back after foaling, which happens occasionally. Sometimes the umbilical cord gets disconnected a little bit too soon, and so we want to make sure that we don't have any excess bleeding to it. And actually, once this stump dries up and everything, it'll just fall off anyway, because that's just what Mother Nature's way of doing it.
What did happen, Jennifer?
I think it just, I think like Buck said, it just broke too soon and just keeps wicking a little bit. But he tied that string he tied on or whatever looks good. It looks like it had quit already, so.
We're going to go ahead and put a little more iodine on the navel now. And I iodined her very good earlier, but we just want to make sure we don't get any infection going up into that umbilical cord, because for approximately 12 hours while that gut's still open, that's where you can... generally, if you're going to have any problems, they'll occur. Isn't that right, Jennifer?
Mm-hmm.
But it looks like we've probably got the problem taken care of here. Well, the veterinarian here, Jennifer, we're going to try and get this cold up. And we've got plenty of colostrum down him now, and we just want it to start building up on its strength a little bit on its legs, because this is an awfully big filly. Don't you think so, Jennifer?
Yeah.
As big as this?
Yep.
And for whatever reason, a lot of mares are over this year. They're going almost a full year, and this baby shows it, because it's amazing when they get this big how fast they're growing.